Hi, my sassies. We need to have a talk. I know it's been a while. But, we've been having, like, a pandemic thing. And, well, if I don't have to go nowhere, it's like, I don't really know what to talk to you guys about. You get bored hearing about the same stuff. Every day is like Groundhog's Day. Every day, same day. Every day, same day. Every day, same day. Every day is the same day. You know, some days I wonder, did yesterday happen? Is today really happening? And when I get to tomorrow, will it really be tomorrow? Because it all seems like today. Or yesterday, or tomorrow, or I don't know what time of the day it is. I have to look out the window. If it's daylight, then I know if it's AM or PM sometimes. I don't know the month, because if you don't remember, change calendar or mark it off, well, and your days are all running together, yeah, that thing's not handy at all. I'm gonna have to find a way to know what day it is. Starting to get a little bit confusing. The only way that I really know that any time has passed is because I see garbage cans go out. And then I see people take them back up to their house and they're not full anymore. So I know it's not just repeating that. But besides that, take a shower, change your clothes, everything else is like the same. Like, nothing happens. It's like time stood still. The pandemic is happening, and nothing else is happening in the world. It's like the world is waiting for us. It's out there, waiting for us to come back. Yeah. You, me, them, everybody. Even little gremlins. It misses us. Don't you miss it? So I figure I better start preparing myself to get back out there in the world, right? Because, you know, schedules change, everything just ran together. So like I said, you don't know if it's day or night or what month it is or heck, maybe even what year it is. I never even thought about that. How long has it been? It's been a long time. We ain't seen nobody or done nothing. I don't know if I can do this. Maybe I forgot how to do all this. Oh, I never thought about that. Did you think about that? So while I'm trying to prepare myself, I thought, well, I'll get up this morning. Well, I set an alarm so I knew it was morning. And I'll have me some coffee. And I'll get myself started so come Monday morning, I ain't gonna be a shock to my system. I'm a little smarter than that. I ain't gonna wait till last minute. I done did that before in my life. I was a little bit sorry that I did things like that. I'm just a little bit smarter now. So, I'm gonna prepare myself. So I got myself some coffee. I put it in the machine. So it made me some coffee. Some Maxwell House Coffee. Mmm, I love the way a good fresh cup of coffee smells, you know? So I got my coffee in my cup. And I put my sugars in it. And a few more sugars. And a few more sugars. You gotta make sure you got enough sugar ratio with the coffee. So, the ratio is a lot of sugars to a little bit of coffee. And then, of course, I had to have some milk in it because I like my coffee sweet and light. And let me tell you, when I took that first drink, tasted just like heaven. I ain't had a cup of coffee in a while. I don't always drink coffee, but it just sounded so good this morning, and I needed something to help me with some energy, you know? So I'm just going along with my morning, drinking my coffee, and oh, tasting so good, I'm liking it, oh yes. And I made sure I made enough coffee for me to have two cups, two large cups, I should say. So I got done with the first one and nothing. None at all. Not even a little bit. I'm like, I'm gonna have to drink that second cup. So I make up my concoction again. Make sure I got a lot of sugar in it. And I start drinking cup number two. Yeah, cup number two. So I'm drinking number two cup. And it's just as good as the first one, of course. And I'm realizing I'm getting to the bottom of that second cup. Still nothing. Not even a little bit. Wait a minute. I had two large cups of coffee. I mean large. Plus I put a whole lot of sugar in it. And still nothing. And I mean nothing. I was puzzled. So I started scratching my head wondering, this has never happened before. But I think my coffee is broken. I mean, it is broken. It didn't work. Coffee is supposed to make you wake up, not feel sleepy. I drank two large cups, and I felt more tired than before I had the coffee. Yep, my coffee was broken. Now what am I gonna do? I ain't never had broken coffee. And I'm a redneck kind of person, so I like, no duct tape can pretty much fix anything. But duct tape ain't gonna fix broken coffee. So, I looked on the can to see what it might say about broken coffee. Maybe it's a thing. I've just always been lucky and my coffee wasn't broken. But today it's definitely broken. And I paid money for this. Somebody needs to fix it. So I didn't find nothing about broken coffee. But it did say something about if you weren't satisfied. But did you know that if the coffee doesn't wake you up or make you feel like you want to stay awake, it's not broken? That's what the man on the phone said. And he was very mean and told me that I shouldn't be playing on the phone. That number was for real people that have a real complaint about their coffee. That's what he said to me. Yeah. So, when I asked to talk to his manager, he hung up. I guess he didn't find any humor in this at all. And I really just wanted to know if my coffee was broken. I mean, he could have just said, coffee doesn't break, and been nice and explained to me why. I mean, some of us, it takes a little more to, you know, understand things. But instead he was mean, and said I wasn't a real person with a real problem, and just hung up on me. So what did I learn from this? Well, I already knew coffee couldn't break. But I thought it was kind of funny. So I thought if I called and did that, that somebody would find humor in it on the other end. And they would laugh and smile for the day. But that backfired on me because the man was a very mean person. And, yeah, I feel sorry for him, but, anyway, my coffee was real good, and yeah, it didn't wake me up, so, I'm gonna have to come up with another plan for waking myself up, so, tomorrow I'll have to think of something else. So, this is the end of my story, and, yeah, I guess, my advice would be, don't call and do that to anybody. Don't call and tell them your coffee's broken, because they're not always nice. And just so you know, yeah, you can see some mess in my room. We got a baby that's about to be due here, and we's moving everything around. I gotta move the whole room around again. So, yeah, I got a bunch of stuff going on. That's another reason I need to find, something that's gonna wake me up, because I got a bunch of stuff to do. So, maybe I have another brand of coffee that's even more strong. Okay, bye my sassies. Much love. Remember, smiles are free.